My not-so-secret love of the underappreciated musical continues this week. What do you get when you throw Gene Kelly, Olivia Newton-John, Jeff Lynne, some tap shoes, some roller skates and a clarinet into a blender? You get 1980s camp cult classic Xanadu. Olivia Newton-John seemed destined for superstardom after the smash success of Grease in the late 70s, but because of Xanadu's big failure at the box office in 1980, as disco began to suck and roller skates were being put in dusty garages to wither away, this movie remains her only film where she receives top billing. Xanadu was released in a year which also saw two other disco musicals hit cinemas: the dystopian 1994 future musical The Apple, and The Village People starring extravaganza You Can't Stop the Music. So it appears that in 1980, disco was on the way out fast, and movie audiences had an abundance of camp musicals thrown at them to even give Xanadu a chance. For me, Xanadu stands out from the three. It's the least disco, for one, opting for a strange but endearing hybrid of old-school Hollywood musical and quote-unquote contemporary rock pop. Now, it helps my argument immensely that I'm both a huge fan of Olivia Newton-John and Jeff Lynne's Electric Light Orchestra, so the music that they both contribute to this film really makes it a great time for me. So obviously, if you're not a fan of ELO or Olivia Newton-John, you are probably not going to enjoy this very much. For me, it's a fun, flashy and campy time that serves as a great showcase for Newton-John's talents, ELO's music, plus a nice little connection to the old style musicals with the addition of the late and great Gene Kelly in his last ever feature film role. This is also a film anyone of any age can enjoy, although I do take a bit of objection with the film's G rating in certain scenes. Holy shit! It's a shame that Newton-John's career didn't really hit the same highs after Xanadu, because her screen presence and her star quality are really big parts of what makes Xanadu a cult favourite. As Danny, the ageing big band aficionado from another era, Gene Kelly is actually quite wonderful. He joined the film on the agreement that there would be no singing and dancing for him, a surprising obligation, but by the end of the film the production convinced him to add his talents to the movie. Xanadu was allegedly written as it went along, meaning the charming sequence where Danny and Kira sing Whenever You're Away From Me was filmed after initial production was finished, and under Gene Kelly's strict conditions that only he, Newton-John, a cameraman and a choreographer friend of his would be present. It's a nice sequence that Kelly himself choreographed and almost resembles a dance sequence he had done with Judy Garland years before in 1942's For Me and My Gal. Olivia Newton-John would later reveal that dancing with Gene Kelly was one of the highlights of her career. As the struggling artist with a sudden inspiration to open a club, Sonny, played by Michael Beck, is the least memorable performance in this, although he makes up for it partly with some rockin' 1980s fashion, including those revealing red striped shorts as he skates along Venice Beach. Michael Beck is a handsome guy in this, but I honestly don't really buy that he's supposed to be so irresistible to women. One dude offers Sonny his daughters, while another duo just let him steal their motorbike, no questions asked. There's a few questionable plot points like this in Xanadu which further the allegation that it was written as it was being filmed. Danny practically gives Sonny the keys to a massive club after knowing him for a few hours, but I suppose we later see that Danny himself has maybe lost his marbles a bit over the years as he starts to see things in his own house. But I digress, the real draw of Xanadu for me is the fantastic soundtrack. Even though the film itself was a failure at the box office in 1980 and it didn't really go down well with critics, its soundtrack went double platinum in the US, and the songs Magic and the title song Xanadu became hugely successful singles for ELO and Olivia Newton-John. The musical sequences in Xanadu are bright and bubbly, and there's a few intimate breaks as well. Olivia Newton-John's songs in this film were produced by John Farrar, the person behind Sandy's Grease ballad, Hopelessly Devoted to You. We have her smash hit Magic as Sonny discovers Kira in the empty auditorium trying out her roller skating skills. There's the love ballad duet Suddenly, where Cliff Richards fills in for the voice of Sonny, and we see some questionable trees becoming erect as Sonny and Kira skate around them. Another reason to question that G rating. There's an awesome sequence to Dancin', which is a highlight of the film as two different eras of music blend together to form one song, giving Sonny and Danny the inspiration for Xanadu. The costumes and choreography here are funky, and the G rating comes into question yet again with some not so subtle orgasmic sounds from the dancers. Could the blending of these two eras of music be a metaphor for inclusion? It's a theory and probably not, but it's a cool sequence nonetheless. We also have this movie's hopelessly devoted to you moment, suspended in time. Beautifully sung by Olivia Newton-John, and a sweet somber moment amongst the bombasticness of the rest of the film. ELO's contribution to the soundtrack, as I've already mentioned, really elevates the film considerably. We have Kira and her Muse sisters' introduction with I'm Alive as their mural turns to life and they pirouette up a storm. There's also a beautifully hand-drawn animated sequence to the sound of Don't Walk Away. Although it was added late in the game to add another ELO song to the soundtrack, it fits in with the fantasy element of the film and complements Kira's magical abilities well. The animation sequence was directed by Don Bluth, who would go on to make Thumbelina and use similar themes and ideas. We have probably the most campy sequence in the film as the trio shop for some new threads for Danny to the tune of All Over the World, a scene filled with colour, drag and an abundance of glam. It's a delightful segment and is likely the most beneficial contribution to the film's camp classic status. They of course save the best song for last, as Olivia Newton-John belts out the title track in the film's big finale, as Xanadu opens for business and people are skating, dancing and performing circus tricks. Had Xanadu been a real club, I'm sure it would have cost a fortune to run and been a massive OH&S nightmare for the owners, but 1980 was a different time. The finale is a non-stop musical extravaganza with the title song intertwined with some brief musical interludes by Olivia Newton-John that are charming, boppy and bizarre all at once. I actually enjoy one song she quickly sings titled Fool and wish that it had featured on the soundtrack as it's a pretty cool tune. In many respects, Xanadu is a product of its time, but certain aspects have kept it alive and kicking throughout the years and made it the cult hit it is today. The rockin' soundtrack, the colourful, campy and brightly lit musical sequences, and a charming and sweet lead performance by Olivia Newton-John. Its devoted following even led to a hit Broadway adaptation of the film, which ran for 500 performances. Although I've never seen this, as the show never made it to Australia, I heard it was pretty good and approached the material in an almost parodical fashion, which just sounds amazing. So if you love ELO and Olivia Newton-John, some old Hollywood style mixed with some 1980-era pop with a touch of camp, then you will likely fall in love with Xanadu the same way I did watching it as a young kid on TV, then getting repeat viewings over the years on DVD, and getting lucky finding the vinyl soundtrack at a local flea market for $5. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't seen Xanadu, let me know what you think in the comments below when you go check it out. The vinyl actually came with this Electric Light Orchestra merchandise offer for roller skates, which is pretty cool, but I think it may be a bit too late to claim it. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Road to Nowhere Films for more content. And until next time, I'll be guiding you.